Good morning students, take page number 15. Today our first topic is connection ports. Okay, connection ports. Connection ports means sockets. Okay, connection ports is also known as sockets. Sockets means in switchboard you can see plug points. Plug points are called sockets. Okay, in computer terms we use sockets or connection ports, which are used to connect our external devices. Connection ports or sockets is used to connect our external devices like keyboard, mouse, printer or USB is connected to our CPU by using this connection ports. And ports are, there are different shapes and sizes of ports, and each port have different functions. Okay, each port perform different functions, and they are differentiated by using the colors also. By using different colors we can able to find it very easily. Okay, so here this is the back side of your CPU, and this is your left and right side of your laptop. Okay, ports are available in back side of your CPU and left and right side of your laptop. So here first one is PS bar 2 port, which means personal system bar 2 port. Where it is? This is, okay, this is also known as keyboard or mouse port. Keyboard or mouse port, this was developed by IBM company. Okay, this was developed by IBM company. So this kind of port is only available in IBM computers. Okay, mostly it is available in only in IBM computers. It is mainly, and it is also used for graphics, to get extra graphics for PlayStations. For mostly they are using for playing games. Okay, PlayStations. And the second one is, and it is not available in laptop. Okay, it is not available in laptop. Second one is Ethernet port, which means your internet port. Okay, network port. So here this is the Ethernet port. Okay, in laptop it is in left side. This is Ethernet port to access the network. Audio jack socket, third one is audio jack socket. You can see here red, green, blue. And in laptop it is in right side. Audio jack means you can connect your headset or your speaker. Okay, and then VGA port. VGA port is used to connect your monitor and the CPU. Okay, it is a connection between the monitor and the CPU. In this is your VGA port in computer. And in the left side of your laptop you can see your VGA port. And at last USB port, you can connect your pen drive. Fifth one is USB port. USB in CPU you can connect your mouse, keyboard. Okay, by connecting your external mouse or keyboard. And here USB port is in your left side. Here also you can connect your pen drive or your keyboard, external keyboard or external mouse. Okay, concept. A port is a connection interface between a computer and other computers or peripheral devices. Port is used for the communication between the computers or between the other computers or between the other peripheral devices. It provides signal transfer mechanism between devices. Okay, it transfers based in the signal method. Okay, it is a connection between the two devices. It is a connection between the two devices. So it is called a signal transfer mechanism. At the back of the desktop CPU box, various ports are available on a panel to connect external devices. These ports are used to connect your external devices. On a laptop, these are available on left and right edges. You can see in left and right edge. Some common ports and their details are as follows. So first one is PS bar 2 port is used to connect your mouse and the keyboard, personal system port. Ethernet port is used to connect your network cable. It is used to connect the network cable. Audio jack socket is used to connect various audio devices like including speakers, microphones and then headsets. Okay. VGA port is used to connect the monitor. VGA port is used to connect your monitor. USB port is one of the most useful port. USB port allows you to attach varieties of devices such as mouse, printer, keyboard, web camera, USB or flash drive, digital camera to the computer very easily and quickly. Most peripheral devices have a USB version only. Okay. In addition, this panel also have power cord sockets and a fan to cool the CPU. In CPU you can see power cord socket, which means it provides power. It provides power to your CPU and also a fan to cool the CPU. So here this is the fan. Okay, this is the fan in CPU. In laptop you can see this is the fan. And this is the connection for the power cord socket. Okay, this is the connection port for the power cord socket. Next topic is power supply. Okay, power supply. The power supply unit in a computer converts the power from the wall outlet, usually AC, to the type of the power needed by the computer, usually DC. Okay. It also convert the AC current to the DC current. Okay. It will convert AC into DC. So this is the power supply unit. Okay. This will connect to each and every devices of your computer. It will connect every devices of your computer. For example, the power supply unit sends power through a cables to the motherboard and the other components. Okay. This power supply unit only, it has so many cables. Okay. Here you can see there are many cables are available on there. So by using these cables, it will connect to your motherboard and our other components also. The power cable from a wall outlet is connected to the socket in this unit. Okay. The power cable from a wall outlet means AC. AC is connected to the socket. Okay. AC motor is connected in the socket. The power button for a computer is usually available on the front panel of the CPU. Okay, you can see a power button in the front side of the CPU only. For a laptop, it is usually available above the keyboard. In computer, you can see the power button in front of the CPU. And in laptop, you can see in the above the keyboard. And the next one is motherboard. Motherboard is directly or indirectly connected to every part of the computer. You can see the motherboard in your laptop, TV and also in computer. Okay. Motherboard is directly or indirectly connected to each and every devices. It also have RAM memory, processor. The main function of the motherboard is to hold the computer's processor and let everything else connect to it. Okay. Each and everything is connected to the motherboard only. The motherboard is the computer's main circuit board. It is a thin circuit plate that contains the CPU, memory, connectors for the hard drive and optical drives, as well as the various external ports and peripherals. So this is your motherboard. Okay, here this is the processor. This is the processor, and here you can insert your memory. And this is very sensitive. Motherboard is, and your motherboard will connect each and every devices. Okay, a port may be connected from inside to expansion cords, which are plugged into the motherboard and are connected to the other components by cables, which are long flat bands that contain electrical wiring. The ports are controlled through the expansion cords. So here this is the expansion cords. Okay, this is the expansion cords. Here you can see the expansion cords on here. Okay, this is the expansion cords in our motherboard. When we see from outside, this is our expansion cords. This will connect other devices also. This will connect other devices and it will connect it to the motherboard. This keyboard, mouse and then VGA port are connected to the motherboard directly. Okay. So this expansion cords are directly connected to the motherboard only. Okay. Thank you.